This is the river Vidyadhari. Once, long ago, along the banks of this tributary of Bhagirathi, between the pre-Maurya era and the Pala period, flourished a great civilization. Chandraketu Garh was probably named after the local regent, Chandraketu. This archaeological site, comprising villages of Bainachapa, Harowa, Shingherati, Hadipur, Shanpukur, and Jhikra, is situated around 25 miles northeast of Kolkata, in the district of North 24 Parganas, under the jurisdiction of Deganga Police Station. In 1906, this place was first brought to the notice of the British authorities by social worker and doctor Sri Taruknath Ghosh of the Chaurasi village, as a result of which, in 1907, Mr. A.H. Longhurst, the superintendent of the archaeological department, inspected these sites. Renowned historian Dr. Rakhaldas Bandopadhyay and archaeologist Paresh Chandra Das Gupta themselves paid a visit in 1909. Many artifacts of different periods regularly showed up at these sites during this decade. In 1920, the British government formally announced this area as a protected place.
We are now in North 24 Parganas around the Bainachapa area at Chandraketu Garh, Raja Chandraketu. According to folklore, Raja Chandraketu ruled over his place around 600 years ago. During his reign, 22 Arabian missionaries came here to preach Islam. One among them was Sayyid Abbas Ali Gaji, locally better known as Pir Gorachand. And Pir Gorachand wanted the king to embrace the Muslim faith, but the king and the queen declined. A battle became inevitable, and what ensued was bloodshed. On his way to the battlefield, the king took two pigeons with him, one white, one black. Rani asked as to why he was taking both the birds. The king exclaimed that if he wins, he will release the white one and the black one will be the sign of defeat. But unfortunately, there was sabotage. As he was almost winning against Pir Gorachand, somebody released the black pigeon. The queen, on seeing the black omen, died of anguish. We are standing at the very point from where the king embarked upon his journey. The Shingher Duar, or the Lion's Gate, as everyone calls it. So now I'm going to show you the Shingher Dar. The logic behind naming this region Shingher Ati is actually the Shingher Duar or the Lion's Gate. On one hand, history based on facts and findings. On the other hand, the stories behind folklore and mythologies that have given rise to many stories relating to the mound of Chandraketu, which has been running since time.
Balanda Archaeological Collection. M.A. Jabbar was born in 1920.
This collection originally belongs to him, and it was because of his steadfast effort that this collection could be put together.
In 1934, Mr. Jabbar, Balanda's local peasant leader, personally took initiative to collect different artifacts of this area. Objects discovered and collected by him between 1934 to 1988 have been preserved in this museum.
1934 to 1935, on the banks of River Vidyadhari, Mr. Jabbar found a huge jwala, a kind vessel which was full of kodi, a kind of shell which was used as currency during that period. This was the first object that was discovered by Mr. Jabbar. Slowly many other objects followed suit. The Lal Masjid or the Red Mosque, the Mazhar of Pir Gora Chand, Pilkhana Mutt and Chandraketu Gaur, red burnt clay brick chiseled stonework, a place of ancient civilization. It became his pastime to explore these places and to hunt for their artifacts. These objects were of the Gupta, Sangha and the Kushan age. Just like in Barachapa we have Chandraketugar, similarly we have found such artifacts in Mahanod in Hooghly district, Ketugram in Bardhaman and also in Chandrakona in Midnapur district. So the realm of Chandraketugar was spread over a huge area. On the north side of the Vidyadhari river, a huge Durga Puja celebration takes place. On this occasion, thousands of people gather around here. Mr. Jabbar first showcased these objects during this festival.
Another person who should be mentioned along with other conservationists is Dilip Kumar Moite. To his credit, he has an interesting collection of antiquities.
Though I was collecting these items from 1952, the museum was started in 1955. Many times as people were digging up a pond or when there was a flood or downpour, these objects of art got revealed. Today I want the government to make a museum here. We are now standing in front of the Chandraketugar Shahidullah Sriti Mohabidyalaya. They have an impressive collection of relics from the Chandraketugar Shahidullah Sriti Mohabidyalaya. So what are we waiting for? Let us pay a visit. Joined here as a principal, it struck me that the name of the college carries the word Chandraketugar and these works of art are found scattered all around and are mostly conserved privately. So I had striven to preserve these art forms here as a public property for research and study by students and teachers alike. The work started in 2003 and the museum was formally opened to the masses on 24 December 2005. We took the students to the villages Hadipur, Shingherati, and we collected materials from the ruins that had been partially excavated and later we received information that many a household have private collections of such materials. Ajibur Rahman, a professor being one of them, he had a collection of black, red and brown pottery which we retrieved. Many villagers voluntarily donated and are still donating art objects out of their free will. Mostly, they are terracotta plaques, some coins too. Few seals in ancient Brahmi jargo. There are some coins and many beautiful works of deities like Yakshini, Parvati, Indra, of which Yakshini idol should be specially mentioned. Ancient plaques depicting sexual union or mithuna, age-old bones and carcasses of different animals, even human fossils, have been found here. This probably is that of an elephant foot patella. This is a vertebra, the molar tooth of Picardium. The jawline of a carnivore, probably a kind of jackal. If it's Mars or a Mercury day, you can go any way. If it rains in early spring, lucky farmer, lucky king. Such famous enunciation is by Connor, the great woman astrologer.
Boraho, the famous astrologer, adorned the court of Chandragupta or Vikramaditya of Abantipur. His son, Mihir, married the Selenese princess Khona, who was more knowledgeable about astrology than Boraho himself. As a result of which, there developed a tension between the two in-laws. Khona and Mihir had to flee to Chandraketugarh in the Gangetic plains ruled by King Samudragupta. This is an age-old folklore that still persists.
In Chandraketugarh region, the most iconic archaeological site is the Mound of Khona Mihir, which is also known as the Mound of Boraho Mihir.
For ages, the society at large and the populace remains mesmerized by these stories of Chandraketugarh and Boraho Mihir. But what have the archaeologists got to say?
Kunja Govinda Goswami, who was trained by Ernest Mackay, excavator of Harappa, was a professor of Sanskrit at the Calcutta University and was in charge of excavations here between 1956 to 1964. Excavations was carried out in two places, the Debaloy or the temple complex site or the Mound of Khona Mihir. These were of the Gupta period. The foundation of this temple complex was made of red mortar, and secondly, the township area, which had a rampart or a peripheral wall all around and was made from burnt clay bricks. This falls on our way to Harua. Most of this barricade has been destroyed by agricultural activities. The period and style of construction of these structures can easily be scientifically ascertained. Stratigraphy has revealed seven layers of construction belonging to different periods. The first is the pre-Maurya, then the Maurya, then the Sangha, the Kushana, the Gupta, the post-Gupta, Palasena age up to the Muslim period and till around 12th century AD. We find evidence of continuous human habitation. The two most distinguishing aspects of Chandraketugarh are 1. The Gupta era temple complex, the like of which has not been found anywhere in eastern India, and secondly, that this place was a center of terracotta clay art. Many a terracotta figurines have been found here. We have also found works of ivory, wood, bronze, and most interesting being that what we call the northern black polished ware of the Maurya era.
The West Bengal State Archaeological Museum. All object d'art excavated officially in Chandraketugarh is in display here. But not only here in India, the artifacts of Chandraketugarh find its place in foreign museums also, like the Art of the Past, New York, Asian Museum of San Francisco, Museum of Indian Art, Berlin, etc. We hope one day this secret civilization of many millenniums at the Chandraketugarh will be revealed to the world at large with great pride and jubilation. And on that day, the history of Bengal will have to be rewritten in golden letters.